RBS Busy Research Academy welcomes to you in another video number 21. Dear friends, in this video, I'm going to discuss the multi-group analysis in Smart PLS practically. I would like to suggest you, before watching this one, please watch my video number 20, where I have discussed the multi-group analysis in Smart PLS theoretically. All the necessary theoretical concepts I have provided in that video. Please watch this one, and then you may watch this one to understand. So for the easiness of my viewers, I have divided this topic, like practical thing, in the two parts, part one and part two. So part one is before you guys. In the multi-group analysis. So dear friends, let us start our discussion. But before this one, my name is Dr. Raimab Sumbro, and I'm from Shahabuddin University, Pakistan. And this is my Smart PLS Academy certificate, which I earned from the Smart PLS Academy, Germany. Okay, so now I'm opening my model. This is my model where the sum of the latent variables are there. Four latent variables are here. The quality, satisfaction, orientation, and loyalty. So I would like to apply the multi-group data analysis techniques on this data. Okay, so here, these are the data, demo 243 records. Total records are 243. And I've also provided a link of this data below this video, and from you can download and you can do perform the same thing in your free time. But I would like to caution you here to they miss that. Whatever the result which I have got, it's not necessarily that you will get the same results, because here I'm doing the multi-group analysis with the help of the permutation. So permutation is a process which if you apply through the permutation, always you will get the different result, but the result would not be significantly different. Insignificant or small differences may be over there, but actually all the time that you will find some of the differences in your data. So that's possible. Okay, double click it. Before applying the multi-group analysis, we have to create the group. Okay, because we have to work on the multi-group analysis. So in order to create the group, we should double click the demo data. And then you have the three here columns, options are there. The first one is the group data. Add the group data if you want to add some they missed your variable, demographic variable, some of the already available, and just you want to add over there. If the thing is there, then if you want to generate, then you can generate. And if you want to clear some of the these like the variable, you can do from this side. But here I want to generate the data group. Just click it, and here, so now I want to work on the basis of the gender. So they right here, gender, and then if you go here, click here, you will find all the variables are indicators which are in your model. So here we have to find our variable of interest, gender. So when you find it, then you will get the two unique values, and here total two. So now two is there because there are the two, male and female, that's why the two is there, that's why the total there is also the two. And this is a minimum case. So as a rule of thumb, that for every variable, at least you must have the 10 observations. So now we have the more than 10 observations. So that's why it's not a problem for us. And now we are going to apply the OK to create the groups. Once if you, it will take time. Okay, now our groups have been generated. So we have to edit this one. So first of all, we edit, and the first one is our male, okay, and then this one is a one. One denotes that the one is for female. One is for male, and two is for female. So here there is a one, okay, and then if again you are required to edit this, okay, this is already edited, okay. Now I would like to edit another one here. So this one is our female. Now see, the already two has been appeared here. So it is better, that means you should go through this paragraph. Although the same things are there, but again, it is advisable for to you. Please go through this one. Okay, let's just, okay, now the two groups have been emerged. I would like to work on the MGA. So now this is our, these are our variables. Now on this variable, I would like to apply the permutation test, because we are going to check out the multi-group analysis with the help of the permutation. So that's why we are going to apply the permutation. So in the permutation, you can, this is the permutation. Okay, so now we have to provide it's the group. Group A is for the male, and a group B is for the female. Okay, so now it is in your own interest to go through all these ones, because these are the explanation of these, all these options. Okay, now the if you have watched out my theoretical video, now I told you that the minimum permutations should be 1000. So here these are the 5000. This is quite good. But the problem with the 5000 is that it will take so much time. If you work on the 1000 permutation, it will take less time. But for having the stable result, you should focus, you should consider the 5000 instead of the 2000, 1000 like this one. Okay, and then another thing was the one tail or two tail. In the same video, I discussed that this is a two tail hypothesis. So we should consider two tail rather than the one tail. Okay, significance level 0.05, it is up to you. You can consider 90%, you can also put 99%, but I consider here 95%, okay? Just start calculations. So now this calculation will take time almost 10 to 12 minutes. It depends on the speed of your, like the configuration of your computer. So now we have to wait till the, this process is not being completed. Okay, that's good. We have got the complete results of the permutation of the long bed. So here, these results of are of the path coefficients. So all these are the path co. There are actually there are six path are there, and the results of every path are available. So, but we are not interested in the path right now. We want to check the results of the MICOM. So how to go? How to reach on the MICOM option? Now we have to consider this quality criteria. At the end of the quality criteria, there is a MICOM. Just click it, we will reach on the MICOM result. A difference here, step number two and step number three. As you are looking here, one flow chart where the, it is start from the step number one, that is a configuration and invariance. Step number two is a compositional invariance. So here, step number two is our compositional invariance. And the third one is about the assess the equality of the composite means and variance. So this is step three is to assess the composite mean and variance. So, okay, so results are not statistical or quantitative results are not available for the step number one. The reason is that the, as there are the two groups are there, so we have provided the same treatment, data treatment to the both group. We have also given the same option to the both group in the permutation. So that's why already the step number one has been established. That means that configured invariance assessment has been established. So when it has been established, then we will go to the compositional invariance assessment. So that's why step number two, we are discussing the compositional invariance assessment. In this one, here you are looking, another few words are there. There is step number two. Original correlation between the composite score obtained from the group one and the group two. So now this original correlation, here it's like, okay, here this is our original correlation. Okay, and then should be greater than or equal to the 5% quantile of the empirical distribution. So this should be greater than the 5%. 5% quantile, quantile, this is our 5% quantile. Now, if you compare that the, all these green colors, so these are higher than these 5% quantile, and the satisfaction is also have the same higher value than the 5% quantile. So that's why you see that their values are in the green color, and all these are statistically they missed significant. So that the, these are the permutation p value. So now all these are statistically significant. Like now we can say the behavioral intention and loyalty, these are statistically significant along with the satisfaction. But unfortunately, our quality does not do so. So that's why that the, our composite invariance has been established for the behavioral intention, loyalty, and the satisfaction. Okay, now we are entering into the step number three, and that is about the assess the equality of the composite means and the variance. How to assess this equality? That's very easy. In this way, we have to check out this is the original mean. As you know, in this third step, we are measuring two things, mean and the variance. So this is the mean and this is the variance. So two things are there. So first, we are going to measure the mean. So now the behavior intention is the mean. This is the value of the behavior intention, and these are the so two bounds are there, lower bound and upper bound. So now check it out, either this value is within this bound or not. If it's not within this bound, that means the behavior the original mean of the behavior intention is not established. So unfortunately, the same is not within the range. So that's why it is statistically also significant. It means that the this mean is not falling in this average. So that means its mean has not been established. Okay, and the same issue is with the quality. Okay, but luckily for the loyalty and for satisfaction, their mean are within the range. So this mean is within the range. If you use the 0.096, now this one is within this range, and then minus 0.1, say with 3, again, this is within the one, this range. And both are statistically significant. It means that the variance of the loyalty, it means the mean of the loyalty and satisfaction have been established. So now we are going towards the checking the variance. So variance falls down here. This is our variance. Yes, these are the values of the variance. So the same situation also with the variance, that the value of the first one is not falling in within this range, 0.775. This 0.775 is not falling within this range. So it means it is not, its variance is also not established. Okay, and then again, if you think that the, again, if you think that the permutation P value is also less than the 0.05, it means it is not significant. Okay, variance for another one that is significant, that is established, and because the this 0.134 is falling within this range, and the same situation is also with this one. So these two are variance are established. Okay, so hence we can say that the variance for the variance and means for the behavior loyalty and satisfaction have been established. Okay, so now another thing, if you want to go into the path analysis, then you can double click it. Now path analysis also given that the path analysis except the quality and behavior intention all are significant because their values are higher than 0.05. It means that the light except the quality behavior intention, there is no significant difference between the male and female. So now our invariance has been established for all these ones. Okay, and then if you talk about the indirect total effects, so these are indirect total effects. Again, except the behavioral quality and behavior intention, two other indirect, loyalty and behavior intention and the quality satisfaction, they have been established, and there is a invariance, that means that there is no much difference between their male and female results. Okay, and here you can also go through, these are there. So now if you would like, now here the segment one and segment two. Now this segment one is for the male, and if you click it, then if you check, if you click the segment two, you will get the somewhat different results. So now segment two is for the female, and indirect effect also there, direct path are also there. Okay, and one, the, I think I consider it is a magic, a wonderful feature which has been like the, adopted by the smart readers. Just mean now you can, by the thickness of the line, you can, by thickness of the path, you can also understand yourself. Okay, so these are some important things are there. Now I would like to tell you how to report these results in your research paper. For this purpose, we have to open the Excel file. Now the Excel file, you are looking here, Excel file has been opened, and in this one, few things are there. So first one is a construct. Okay, configural invariant is a first step, compositional invariant is a second step, and the full measurement model invariant is a third step. So these three steps are given here. Okay, Now the there are the four constructs is already you know, and their configuration invariance has been fully established of all one. Okay, so far the composition invariance is concerned, except the quality, all other have is been established. Okay, so in this way you can report your results for any such journal, for your if you're writing it, working on the PhD thesis, you can report these results in such a way. So now this is the mean original difference and this is the variance original difference. Okay, so now behavior intention, the same results are not equal. Their means are not equal. Again, their means are not equal. And again, their variance are not equal here. So hence, the full measurement invariance has not been established for the quality and the behavior intention. Neither the full and not the partial have been established, because if we talk about the partial, that at least one, either the variance or the mean should be significant, but unfortunately no one is significant, so that's why we have to write down the not established. Full measurement invariance has not been established, the same case with this one. And now the for the loyalty and the satisfaction, the full measurement invariance has been established. Okay, dear. So this is all about the part one of this practical video. I hope you like this one. And now, again, I want to remind you that the link of this data and this file I have left below this video, you can download this file and you can download also the data which I have used, and you can apply all these techniques in your free time. Till that time, please take care of yourself and also take care of this channel. Thank you very much. Thank you.